You may have noticed that we've been celebrating women at the lab lately, and that's because March was Women's History Month. To round that all up, for this episode of Inside the Lab, we wanted to take a look at what it's like to be a female scientist at the lab and how that's changed through the years. So let's take a little trip back in time.
The lab was, I would say, if I will have to just generalize, a male white place. The percentage of women was very, very low. I saw only men and no diversity. I am Luisa Hansen, and I have been at the lab for almost 55 years. They told me there was one more woman, but never I saw it. Today we have 22% of women scientists at the lab, 22, 23. Then things have changed and all in a positive way. Also, we have a very diversified lab, and there are many points that need to improve yet, but overall, it's a big positive change.
The lab is actually a great place for women to work, with benefits like continuing education and generous maternity leave. This means that women aren't discouraged from advancement because they don't have to choose between careers and having families. Women can be students, scientists, and mothers. Even though women in science have come a long way since the 50s, there still exists a gender gap in some STEM fields. Women make up a little more than half of the world's population, and these days we earn a little more than half of the bachelor's degrees. Of those, women earn about 50% of the bachelor's degrees in science and engineering fields, which is awesome. But if you look a little closer and break it down by field, in 2012, women only earned about 18% of the degrees in engineering, computer science, and physics. The percentage of women holding degrees in these subjects decreases when you look at master's degrees and PhDs, and these numbers decrease overall for minority women. This imbalance radiates up into most of the STEM workforce, too. Fields like geoscience and mechanical engineering only show about 30% women in their ranks.
What I found is that when I work with people with different backgrounds, we have more ideas at the table. We have more people who are not locked into one way of thinking. And because of that, the creative output of what we do is so much stronger. I'm Carol Woodward, and I've been at Livermore National Laboratory for almost 20 years, and I'm a computational mathematician. Largely in this environment, in CASC and computation at Livermore, has been fantastic for women. I work in what I consider a completely gender-neutral workplace. I don't hear that from every part of the lab. There are challenges that people have.
Often, something called unconscious bias can actually keep young girls from entering STEM fields or young professionals from climbing the ladder. That's why we think it's important to talk openly about these issues, to recognize the problems, and to make change so that everyone of every background can feel comfortable, welcome, and productive in their work environment.
My best advice is don't give up. It's a really cool job. You want to do it, you want to stay with it, keep going, because it's worth it.
In a good way, you can say, well, I know so much, I can do this, I am able to do this, I would like to participate. Always take the initiative.
I'm Celeste Urban, and I'm a biomedical scientist.
I'm Monique Warren, and I'm an environmental engineer.
I'm Maya Goldclay, I'm a computer scientist.
I'm Monica Moya, and I'm a biomedical engineer.
I'm Vanessa, and I'm a chemical engineer.
And I'm a research engineer.
I'm a mechanical engineer.
I'm a material scientist.
I'm a software developer.
I'm a physicist.
I'm a hydrogeologist.
I'm a computer scientist.
I'm a radioactive waste analyst.
An environmental engineer.
A materials engineer.
Nuclear engineer and plasma physicist.
A computer scientist.
Material scientist.
So what will you be? Are you a woman in a STEM field, or do you aspire to be? What changes do you want to see happen in the future? Let us know in the comments down below. Click here to see more of how the lab promotes women in STEM fields, and click over here to watch our last video. And don't forget to subscribe to stay up to date with everything that's happening inside the lab.